Hello, welcome to Binary School. Today we're going to look at the binary representation of a decimal number that is signed negatively in the exponent and the mantissa. Now, to refresh our memories, the exponent is there, the mantissa is there, and the sign is there. So let's have a look at this number. Negative, negative. Okay, so that's the first time we may have come across this problem. So what we need to do, because it's in 2's complement, is to reverse all the digits, to flip all of the digits. Let's start with the exponent. So all the ones become 0. Well, that's nice and easy. All the ones become 0. All the zeros become ones. Okay. Now, the cardinal rule, the 2's complement, is that you add 1 to the flipped digits. So I'm going to add 1 to the exponent. This is going to be quite straightforward. So, that's 1, 0, 0, 0. So, my exponent has a value, and remember, it was signed negatively, so it's minus. Minus 1, that means the decimal point, or the binary point, moves 1 place to the left. 1 place left. Just to remind myself. Okay, so let's have a look at the mantissa. We need to add 1 to the mantissa. We say minus 1. Minus sign there, because it's a minus number, I want to make sure that I remember. So we now have an exponent of, or mantissa rather, of 1, 1, 1. Now remember, we assume, unless told otherwise, that the binary point is between that digit and that digit. Right, so let's make a little bit of space, shall we? Just take that out for a moment, so we know we're getting 2's complement. So what have we got? We've got, before we apply the exponent, 1.11. And the value of the exponent is 1. That means it's a negative number. So that means we move the decimal point of the binary point 1 place left. So the 0 there, I move that there. So that's where the binary point now ends up. Let's just tidy this up. So mine, and it's a negative number. Now, my number is minus 0.111. Now, can we remember how the fractions are represented in binary notation? Just want to clear some space here for us to work on that. So we say, right, so in our number system that we're used to dealing with, we have tenths, hundredths, and thousandths, all the way down to infinity. Yes, there's a pattern. It increases by a power or decreases by a power every time. Exactly the same with binary decimals. Almost exactly the same. Point one, because we can only deal with ones and zeros.
Please contact reception.
Point 1 is a half. Point 0.01 is a quarter. Guess what's coming next? Point 0.001 is an eighth. And we can see that there's a pattern here. Half, quarter, eighth. It reduces by a half every time. This was to be written as notation. It would be 2 to the minus 1, 2 to the minus 2, 2 to the minus 3. So we've got a half plus a quarter plus an eighth. Well, good job, I did some research beforehand. For a half is 0.5, a quarter is 0.25, and an eighth is 0.125. So I'll just total those up. Just going to fill in some zeros there so I can keep myself straight. 5, 7, 8, put the zero in on the point. So our deanery number is 0.875, but it started off signed negatively, so our number becomes minus 0.875. Thank you very much.